Thank you very much, Professor Kelly. Colleagues, our presentation today is on the online mathematics diagnostic test. In short form, we call it OMDT, and a tool to identify gaps in numeracy. Okay, this is an online test given to all first year science students, but it is not limited to science students only. Right, even the social science and the business student can also do this online test. All right, so in our presentation today, okay, we look at a brief introduction about the OMDT. Then we look at the success of OMDT through the eye of pilot runs. Okay, pilot run result and analysis, student feedback, progress and development. Okay, in that we are going to look at the reworked question bank in the Moodle, and then the fully functional online remedial. And after that, we look at the future of OMDT. Okay, also Mr. Amitesh Kumar here with me, who will look at the detailed explanation about the OMDT that's online on Moodle. Okay, so that's a brief introduction about the about this online test. Okay, as I've said that this test is not only for the science student, but anybody who is enrolled in the first year degree level program, right, he or she can do this test. Right, because actually we see that most of our science courses, they depend heavily on mathematics, so a student need to have a good mathematical background in order to do most of the science courses well. But even we see that most of the students who come from Form 7 level or from even from the Form 6 level to the foundation course or from the foundation to the degree level course, they lack mathematical skills. So in 2008, the Faculty of Science, Technology and Environment, they decided to develop a test of this kind. But this is very much similar to the ELSA test, but the only difference is that this test is online, right? So other than being the paper-based, right, we have designed this test on the Moodle. And there are many advantages for an online test, which I'm going to discuss that later on. And of course, this test is very much similar to the literacy test around many of the universities. Right, compared to the universities in Australia and New Zealand, they also have a similar kind of mathematics diagnostic test for the first year students. All right, so we just look at the success of this OMDT. Actually, the development started in 2010, and in last year it was first offered to the students. And just because this test is on the Moodle there, so there are many advantages for that. So because actually once the student completes that test, then he or she will be able to see what the scores is. And also we are going to identify the strength and the weaknesses, right, in which area the students are doing well, in which area the students are not doing well. So based on that, we also have that, we have the remedials. And the remedials are again online. And for the face-to-face student, we also have the remedials in the first week of every semester. Right, so there are many topics which comes under mathematics, such as algebra, calculus, trigonometry, etc. And right, so whichever area the students are facing problems, so they can attend the that particular remedial session. And if they are not willing to attend the online session, then of course they can then just attend the face-to-face one. And we have more than 600 students enrolled in the science program in the first year, right, from the all the campuses. All right, and we also have the forums, the PISI forums and the active forums in the Moodle there, through which the students can communicate with the lecturers. All right, so I just call upon Mr. Amitesh Kumar, right, who will then discuss about the what kind of development we have on this test. Right, so Mr. Amitesh Kumar.
Thank you, Dr. Prasad. Morning to you all. In fact, this numeracy test, online mathematics diagnostic test, was initially started. I was the person who has done the research on this through the 15 different universities around the UK, New Zealand, Australia, as Dr. Prasad has mentioned. And what we have found out through the research was these universities, they have this numeracy test in them, so that they can assess the student, like what we have, the literacy ELSA test at university. This is a very similar test to that, and the major advantage here, it will be using the ICT tools to deliver the content of mathematics to our students, and this is, let's say, of the traditional method which students has already adapted to learn mathematics. Now, this test consists of four major topics, and in those major topics, they have got plenty subtopics. So what we have done, what the OMDT team has done, it has used the feature, randomization feature in Moodle to develop this test. Now, while developing this test, we came across a lot of obstacles and a lot of other meaningful features which we could have used to deliver the content in a successful way. Now, this slide basically talks about how the OMDT test, the numeracy test, was set up on Moodle. We had 20 subtopics, and each subtopic has got 50 questions, and these questions were of different strength. And we name it as easy and hard, 25 questions with the strength of easy and 25 of hard. And then there are 20, that means a total of 1,000 questions from different subtopics. And the actual test, numeracy test, it consists of only 40 questions. Now these 40 questions, it comes from different banks, 20 different banks. And the time allowed for this test was 60 minutes. In fact, this is how the questions were set up. Let's say bank 1, a subtopic, has 50 questions of two strengths, and then bank 2 has another 50 questions. Likewise, bank 3, and it continues to the 20th bank, which has got another 50 questions of different strength. Now, only two questions from each bank goes for the main online diagnostic test, and it contributes to 40 randomized questions. And please note, this randomization is a built-in function in Moodle, and again we can work on it too, or use AI to enhance it. And once the students has done this test, the results are very quick and immediate on Moodle, and they can find it on the mark sheet. And please note, for this, students need to have USB ID and password to log in and do the test. Now, once we set up the questions, the test, it was time to pilot the project, and then these are the different answers that we have got. And the students count per campus. It was first time offered at all the campus. So you can see it is of the graph over there. It shows all the campuses. And again, like I have said, we had two strength of questions, easy and hard. We also offered this question as a pilot to foundation students, and we wanted to see how and what they feel regarding this. And this table shows here the mark range, the number of students have set for the test, the percentage pass, and average marks. And the major thing we have noticed here is the percentage pass. It is 17.11%. Now, what does this mean is that students really need this test.
Or it's too hard.
Yeah. And then you can see here the number of students have got 1 to 9 and 10. Wow. Now, you might be thinking that students have scored 0 or from range 1 to 9. No, that is not the usual case. What we found out that the students were not really aware of how to go around using Moodle and how to take this test. So while they're taking this test from their campuses, what they have done, in fact, once they start the test, that, and if there is an internet connection problem over there, then this what happens is this test times out. And as I have said earlier, it's only for 16 minutes and the attempt is only one. So if their session is out or logged out, that means their submitted results will be either zero or whatever range they fall in. So that's why the number over here is pretty high. And going forward, after this test, what we wanted to make this project a really successful one. So what we did, try to get some feedbacks. And these are some of the words which students have used heavily to describe numeracy test. Some of them, they find it really challenging, and it was really applicable to what they have been enrolled in the USP and their programs. The strength of it, and it needs to identify what problem they are facing it. Please note these feedbacks were collected from the Pacific Forum on Moodle. And this feedback, it shows what problems they really faced while doing the test. Now you can see this slow really bolded over here, the Wi-Fi and the distribution. This part, these words really explains what their really real problems were. So the Wi-Fi over here, let's say if a student is taking a test at university and then the Wi-Fi problem is there is a problem or there is a connection problem, then they are timed out and they score less. Or maybe if they have, out of 40 questions, they only attempt 2 questions, then when the time or session goes out, the test is automatically submitted and they get the results less. So another student feedback. I don't know why it's not appearing. But if you go here and see this, these are the questions which were real questions which we posted on Moodle, and using Likert scale, this is what they got, if it is clear to you guys.
How many responses again?
There were 672 students who have responded this descriptive analysis. And this shows that 64.45% of the students felt that they like reading and doing mathematics test online. So that means that students are now moving from their traditional method of learning, which was learning mathematics on pen and paper, to online. And then later we have done with the pilot, and then now it was time to, once we have identified the problem in students, now it was time to design and develop the remedial. In fact, to bridge that gap which was created earlier when they moved from secondary school to the testing institute. Now we are trying to bridge those gaps. So what the OMDT team did, they tried to add another set of 1,000 questions on the Moodle, and then these questions were moderated by the mathematics and stats staff of university, and again the preparation of remedial modules. The content was being prepared by the OMDT team, and then again it was moderated by the university staffs, MAST staffs. And this remedial is the next phase we are working on, the team is working on, so most probably next year in the forum we'll be presenting our next phase of the project, and thus this will complete the project. The future of online mathematics diagnostic test. What we are trying to do, like I have said earlier, we are integrating ICT into mathematics learning. So we're trying to give all the feedbacks and results in the graphical way for students to get a fair idea on, let's say some of them, if there are 40 questions, they won't really know which their own strength by looking at the marks only. If we provide, like many stats geniuses said, that looking at graphs, people understand more. And are fully functional and interactive online, as I have just said. And the remedial modules to be matched with another project we are having at the moment, and the mobile app for OMDT. This is having Android and iOS. We are planning on it, and we'll be working on it in the coming years. Basically, that's all we have.
Well, that's enough. That's good. That's good. So thank you for that.